Driver's licenses and passports are a thing of the past. ID management platforms on the blockchain will not only transform the way personal information is handled globally, but it has the ability to enhance equality. This is quite a disruptor for a market that is forecast to reach $9.7 billion by 2021. That's up from $8.7 billion in 2016. For the 1.1 billion people around the world who don't have the means to get a national identified status, this could change their lives and bring them into the economy. Stateless persons, women in some countries, and refugees, they're all deeply affected by the lack of formal identity. Decentralized ID, or sovereign identity, is a radical concept. Up till now, identities have been defined by the governments under which you live, or by financial institutions. Now, many companies are examining and testing blockchain technology, mainly how smart contracts can be an irrefutable certificate of authenticity. This is the next wave of the internet and the digital economy. Microsoft is betting big on this. Last June, Microsoft and Accenture unveiled a blockchain prototype for ID 2020 that is powered by a private version of the Ethereum blockchain. The service has already been used in the field by the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees to enroll 1.3 million refugees in 29 countries. The reason this is an equalizer is because decentralized ID platforms cut through traditional ID application requirements, like needing a verifiable address, a utility bill, or birth certificate. By the way, a dominant factor that inhibits refugees or people from informal settlements from obtaining identification is the lack of proof of a formal residence. This can keep them from getting aid, money transfers from family, and healthcare. Microsoft is now testing the scalability of decentralized ID management platforms for wider adoption. Their next step will be users allowing Microsoft Authenticator to act as your user agent to manage ID data and cryptographic keys. They are also working on ID hubs, a cloud-enabled way to store and access your sovereign identity. But to truly understand if ID management is scalable, I looked to see which governments are adopting or flirting with this concept. There are several. Brazil's Ministry of Planning, Budget, and Management is piloting a blockchain identity application using Uport, a self-sovereign ID platform built by Consensus. And in Canada, IBM Interconnect and Secure Key Technologies are working together to enable a new digital identity and attribute sharing network based on IBM blockchain. Early adopters of this technology stand to be the pioneers of the next wave of innovation, or Web 3.0, where the internet becomes a utility that makes life more efficient, a space that equalizes opportunity. So yes, complete integration of decentralized ID management is a few years off, but soon I believe I'll be able to, let's say, sign up for a social media network and not have to provide my birthday, mother's maiden name, and phone number, or really anything else I don't want to give out. I'll be able to digitally verify who I am without giving countless personal details to hundreds of entities. I'm Tamara Laine, and this is Karma.